This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to find the x and y intercepts of rational functions. And the whole trick here is to remember that the x-intercepts occur whenever y equals 0, and the y-intercept will occur when x equals 0. Okay? So let's try a couple of examples and see how this works. Here I've got y equals x plus 3 over x squared minus x minus 20. When you're dealing with rational functions, the first thing to do, usually, would be to factor them as much as you can. So let's turn this into x plus 3 over the factored denominator, x minus 5 times x plus 4. And if we want to find the y-intercept, we have to remember that x is going to equal 0 at that point. So we'll turn all the x's into zeros. So we're going to have y equals 0 plus 3 over 0 minus 5 times 0 plus 4. And that just turns into a 3 over negative 5 times 4 is negative 20. So I'll call that negative 3 over 20. That's the y value. The x value, of course, is 0. So the y-intercept is going to be at the point 0, comma, negative 3 over 20. Okay, so let's get rid of this and find any x-intercepts. So remember, the x-intercept occurs, or x-intercepts occur, whenever the y value equals 0. Okay, so let's get rid of that y, put in a 0. Now, for this rational expression, this equation on the right, to equal 0, all we have to do is make the numerator equal to 0. If I want to make the numerator equal to 0, I've got x plus 3, so that would mean x would be negative 3. That would turn the whole thing into a 0. So I've got x equals negative 3. That's going to be the x value for my x-intercept. The point of that intercept is going to be negative 3 comma 0 for my y value, because x-intercepts occur whenever y equals 0. Okay? Let's do one more. Okay, here we've got y equals x squared plus 5x minus 14, and that's over x squared plus 5x. Once again, we'll start out by factoring this. That's going to turn into x plus 7 times x minus 2. In the denominator, I can factor an x out of that expression, so I'll have x times x plus 5. Okay, so to find the y-intercept, I want to turn the x's into zeros. So I would have y equals 0 plus 7 times 0 minus 2. The denominator is going to be 0 times 0 plus 5. Now, if you think about it, this is going to be a problem, because the denominator, 0 times 0 plus 5, is going to equal 0. We can't have a 0 as a denominator. So this will not have a y-intercept. Instead, what we've got here is a vertical asymptote at x equals 0. Okay, so there is no y-intercept for this function. Let's see if we can find some x-intercepts. So for the x-intercept, we want to set y equal to 0. So I have 0 equals x plus 7 times x minus 2 over x times x plus 5. I'm just worried about what would turn the numerator into 0. So if I think in terms of x plus 7 turning into 0, that would mean x would have to equal negative 7. If I want to turn that x minus 2 into a 0, that would have to mean that x would have to equal positive 2. So I will have two x-intercepts. One is going to be at the point negative 7 comma 0, and the other is going to be at the point 2 comma 0. Okay, so that's the whole trick to doing this. Remember, start out, factor your rational expression. Then, to find the y-intercept, turn all your x's into zeros. Make sure you don't have any 0 as your denominator. To find the x-intercepts, set the rational expression, the right side of the equation, equal to 0. And really, all you have to do is find out what would turn the numerator into 0. Okay? That's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.